My name is Jamal Graham. I'm from Siena, Chicago. I'm a junior and I play linebacker.
My name's Albert Cruse. I'm from Chicago, Illinois. I went to Hubbard High School and I'm a junior defensive lineman.
I played football at De La Salle Institute, Southside Chicago, around 35th Michigan, right down the street from, you know, White Sox Stadium. Pretty much what made me come here is I visited, the coaches were great, I spent time with the players, they had a great time with them, and I felt comfortable, like I felt like this was home, and it really brought me here.
So I played my high school football at Hubbard High School in Chicago. What brought me to USF is I went to junior college in Kansas, and you know, just to get as far away as I possibly can. And I felt I didn't really like the distance, so I came back.
Oh, it's been great. You know, Cruz is also from South Side of Chicago, and like at first guy, I was like, all right, I have another Chicago kid here, so I pretty much relate where I'm from, and pretty much the same. But Cruz is like a high energy, energetic, 100% every time, all the time. He's a great leader, and it helps having another leader on the defense, not just myself, but Eric Davis and Breon and a few other people, and it's just great. And to have him is just exceptional, and it pushes us to be better defense. And we've pretty much held our own versus every offense this entire season.
It's been great playing with Jamal. He's a blur out there, you know, hard-hitting vocal linebacker, you know, and it's, you know, he makes the D-line better, he makes the whole defense better.
I would say leadership, you know, like we all work hard. You know, Jesse Hogan, who's been a 4-year starter from Georgia, I mean, he's been Cruz, Eric, but we've all been just working hard. We give it our all, everything. We try our best to motivate not just ourselves, but motivate everybody around us to be the best players they could be. And it just pushes, not only pushes the defense, it pushes the offense to do better. So just everything just correlates with one another. Pretty much what I try to do is I try to make, when I do make a big play, I try to like get very loud, get very excited, just to get everybody excited. And that very first play of the game, you want like a TFL, you want a sack, you want just a really big, a huge hit and a huge play, which starts off the momentum for the entire game. And I pretty much believe, if we start off loud and fast, we'll finish the game loud and fast.
Well, personally, what I do to bring intensity is that I try to get at least one sack or get to the quarterback at least one time in the game. You know, I feel like a sack is just such a huge play because, you know, the offense has this elaborate passing play set up and the quarterback's dropping back and he's looking to make his reads, and then everything just comes to a complete end. Everything stops. And I feel like that gets us hype and, you know, it kills their momentum, really.
This is a great experience, you know. I was glad I worked really hard in the offseason. I've been here for 4.5 years, I think, roughly, since my freshman year. And I've worked every offseason harder and harder to get better and get better. And it was a great accomplishment, but I know I want to be a first team and I want to be an All-American, so I'm going to work even harder to get that this year and possibly get even next year. So I'm just going to keep on working hard to just win as everything I can.
Well, my battle scars on my helmet, it just come from flying around, hitting hard all day. You know, it's just, camp is just nonstop, bang, 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 bang. So, you know, I try to set the tone with my hits. And, you know, sometimes you knock off a little paint here and there. And the reason I decided not to get it painted, repainted, was because I wouldn't get it back until next season. I couldn't switch helmets. I'm a very superstitious guy, so I feel like that would just mess everything up.
I would say as a captain, our role is to be, you know, no matter what happens, no matter what bad play happens, no matter if they score, no matter what, as a captain, we're supposed to be able to stand up, be able to lead our team through all adversity, good or bad, doesn't matter. We have to be able to say, we're fine, we're gonna still win this game, and we're gonna shut this team out for the rest of the game. And it means being vocal. It means just really, really just being a part of the team, keeping everybody together pretty much no matter what happens.
Yeah, it's important to, you know, keep everybody focused through all the bad plays, because football is the type of game, you know, you're going to have your ups and downs. So you got to be calm under pressure as a captain. And something I think I bring to the team is I think of myself as like the spiritual leader of the captain, of the team. Whatever I can say before we start, before we take the field, to get my teammates hype, I'm gonna come up with it, even if it means coming off the top of my head with some outrageous quote or anything like that.
I would say the biggest thing is things never really go as planned, and all you can do is give it 100%, give it all your effort, and you never fault yourself. If you can go out there each play, every time, give it 100% and do your job every single play, you will never, ever be mad at yourself, and you'll never get mad at anybody else.
You know, I second what he said. You know, Coach Curry says it all the time about going 1-0 and, you know, putting that player behind you and focusing on this play right here. And that's probably the biggest thing I'll take from this season.
Our goals as a team, I would say first as a defense, we want to just keep dominating like we've been dominating all year. And as a team, we just want to win the rest of these games, give it all our effort, still come out, practice every day like this means something to all of us. And we want to make sure we let our seniors leave on a good note, and let them show them that we really appreciate them.
Yeah, the biggest goal as a team is to win the rest of these games. And like he said, let our seniors go on a good note, on a winning note. And individually speaking, I'm 3 sacks away from the career sack record here at USF, so I'm pretty charged up about that.